We believe in sharing journeys and touching lives. You are watching A Walk with Mel, and today we're taking a walk with the beautiful, the fabulous Beata Green, an entrepreneur, actor, and public speaker. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this fabulous journey with us. Hello and welcome to A Walk with Mel. Today we're hanging out with the beautiful Beata Green all the way from Cape Town, and we're at this fabulous, fabulous place, Healy's Cheese. So exciting. She's like, Antini Platters is open, don't play. So exciting to have you on the show, man. And I mean, I had the honor of meeting you in Arendsvlei. Yeah. But your journey started way back, obviously. I mean, for the people that don't know, give us an introduction of who you are, where you're from, and what was life like growing up for you.
Okay, so first of all, I just want to say thank you for having me. I've been watching the show and it is amazing.
Thank really. You so much.
I am an actor, as I've mentioned before, and I am a business owner. I am one of five children, so I have two older siblings. Two older sisters, and an older brother and a younger brother.
Wow.
So I've got a big family. And growing up, I really felt it.
I can imagine.
having many siblings and, you know, sharing everything.
Obviously. So you're a sharer.
That was the benefits of it. Yeah.
Wow.
And I'm a student as well. I'm busy with my master's at the moment.
Amazing.
And I love cheese. I love
as
coming
to Healy's
as well. And yeah.
What was life like for you growing up? I mean, you were a hit girl, and that's already like, ooh, is she a geek? Was she cool? What kind of girl were you when you grew up, when you were obviously in high school?
Okay, so in high school, head girl, I would consider that like the end of growing up. So that was like the cherry on the cake of growing up.
I got you.
Before then, in primary school, I was introverted child. I was shy.
Are you serious?
I didn't smile a lot.
And look at this beautiful smile.
I was shy of smiling.
Are you serious?
So if you would tell me something sweet, I would smile, but then I would suppress it. So I would do this. And then my art teacher would always tell me, smile.
Make it open it up.
Yeah.
And that's funny.
So I was very shy. I was very introverted.
Wow.
And I thought a lot, so
wow.
I like to think that I was, you know, just figuring life out, because when I got to high school, things changed. I started doing public speaking and drama and all those things, and nobody knew that I could do it because I was so quiet.
Really?
And because I was so shy.
Amazing.
And I remember my dad always told me that when I was younger, he asked me to do something in front of the family because all the cousins were dancing. And I said, no, daddy, I'm shy.
I'm shy
like the sun. And I didn't know, but I know I shine. So
I'm shy. So, but you're still shining. Look at you now. You're shining on the show. You're shining on Arendsvlei. Do you think that acting helped you with that? To get out of your shell? Do you think that kind of...
I don't think acting helped me. I think acting was a way that I could express
Lovely.
Myself. So doing it, it wasn't like I had to start and learn to come out. It was like I used
it made
the character.
Sense to you.
To speak out, you
sure.
know, I found confidence in the character. And funnily enough, slowly, that started becoming a part of who I was.
Wow.
And I could be that person, and I could manage to become head girl of my school and be known as the speech maker.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Amazing. It's so cool. Sometimes you think, I always say, you think you know someone. You know, we work together on set, but I mean, now I feel like I'm getting to know you, you know. What do you think, what was the first step that led you to where you are now on your journey?
Ooh, there were many steps. One very important step was definitely having so many siblings and not being like an only child or someone that got a lot of individual attention. So because I was so shy, I was a very underwhelming child. So I didn't perform very strong in my younger years, like academically, dance-wise, in anything really. With my siblings, they were like amazing.
Okay,
so
I get you.
That like growing
it molded
up in
you,
there,
no?
Growing up in their shadow molded me in a way, because it instilled ambition and drive and good work ethics in me.
I can relate to
that. And that, at the end of, like, my mom would always say, I'm where I am today because of the choices I made as Beata, not because of things that were handed to me, you see.
Yo.
So those things allowed me to become so emotionally intelligent that I could make those things happen.
That's dope. I'm so glad that you shared that, because a lot of times, I mean, we all go through things. I mean, the viewers watching, the youngsters watching, sometimes you think you are the product of your circumstances, that maybe they are in every circumstances, but it's a choice. You know, you made a choice to be who you are today. You chose that.
I firmly believe that.
And then tell us about the arts. Was it always part of your life, or what was your first introduction into this industry?
Not this industry, but art, was when my parents got divorced and my mom signed my eldest brother and I up for art classes. Funny story. Funny story, in grade art, I used to love drawing.
Okay.
And they taught us how to draw stock mannequins, like they call it.
Yes.
And I was beyond stock mannequins at that
next
stage.
Level.
Because I love drawing.
I agree.
But then the teacher said, you must draw a stock mannequin.
So what
I did was, I drew the stock mannequin, but I drew knees and elbows on the stock mannequins and like curves and things. And that's when they realized, okay, I've got...
What? You see beyond this.
Yeah, and I've got a knack for art, and then I started with art.
Amazing.
Like I said, drama is something that came with time. It was an escape. And it's just one day I just sat and I watched. I remember I was in grade 8 and I watched a drama production, and I thought to myself, I see myself there. And I had no evidence that I would be good at it or that I had the ability to do it, but something inside of me just went...
What?
That is where I see myself. And I think that's just destiny.
It is.
I think there's so much out there
like
in the universe.
You can't picture yourself doing something else. I can't picture myself doing... The other day I thought about it. I was like, I can't picture myself doing something else other than acting.
Yeah.
I love it so much that I don't want to do anything else, you know, than that, you know.
I've got a few things though, not just that specific thing, but like that feeling that you have of knowing.
Mm.
It's something that's in you. We don't see it. People don't tell us. It's just in you. And that's how it started.
Lekker money, because all are they. What would you say is the vision for you now as an artist? What's the vision for you?
The vision for me is to create.
Mm-hmm.
And I studied drama, but I didn't study acting. I studied the technical side. So there was no performance involved. It was all set building, stage management, editing, that sort of thing. So just everything behind the scenes.
Amazing.
So I want
but
to...
I mean, with this face... You put it on camera, okay? Anyway.
It takes a lot more than a face to act.
I know, I know. But you've got the screen presence already, you know?
Yeah.
But anyway, yeah.
But thank you.
Yeah.
So I want to produce. I want to create stuff.
Okay.
And create jobs and tell stories, because that's so important. That's why we do what we do.
Mm.
We inspire people. We educate people. Instill things in them. We make them see themselves on screen.
You give
them
hope?
That's why of the show that we're doing together now, Arendsvlei, there's a lot of people that see themselves in it.
It's
so
they can relate to the character.
That is what I want to do. I want to continue creating jobs. I want to continue telling stories.
Sure. Love it. And then, I mean, you spoke about you've done all the technical stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You've done your degree in drama as well as it's a BA and then your honors as well.
Mm-hmm.
How important is it to have education and to just get that training, you know, for what you want to do in future?
Mm-hmm.
And how did it add value to your journey so far?
It added a lot of value
mm-hmm.
because I learn things that I don't necessarily learn in the industry, and those are things about myself, things about how I work under pressure and how to manage time, really, and that's where studies come in.
Mm.
Education is extremely important, but it is also important to realize that there are various forms of education, and it doesn't have to take place in a university or a college, and people are inclined to be good in different things, and it's important to acknowledge that you can be a success if you take a different path. Education comes in many forms.
Kiki, ik voel deze workshop. Nou, ik zie veel ook with Mel. Hanging out with Beata Green people. Taking a quick break, don't go anywhere. It's a walk with Mel. I want to taste from this cheese as well. Healy's cheese in the building. Welkom terug. Het is A Walk With Mel. Het is Stappen met Beata Green out here in the building. And we're hanging out at Healy's Cheese, people, if you just joined us. We spoke about your journey earlier and who you were basically as a person, how you got into acting. And now I want to speak about Kim, your character on Arendsvlei. It's so cool to see that character grow. I mean, let's talk about that. Can you relate to her as a character? And what has the experience been like for you so far?
It's been such a learning curve.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't do any roles before I did chem, so it was the very first thing I did. I just started acting after studying the technical course, so it was really a going in for a trial and error, and then it growing was just such an exciting adventure because I wasn't expecting it, and I don't think my family was expecting it. I can relate with her because I've done a lot of research about her thought processes, and that's such a nice thing. And I spoke to my friends about it the other day. When you play a character that's not always likable and that doesn't always have popular opinions, it's so refreshing because you have the opportunity to understand why they do what they do and why they say what
that
they say, right?
Yes.
And that teaches you as a person so much. So walking in and saying, in school I would not have been friends with a Kim, but now I would definitely be friends with a Kim because I know where she's coming from.
You understand her.
You learn that you need to have empathy for people less judgment. You need to try and understand where they come from and help one another. And I have so much fun because she is so different from me. She's younger than I am. She is more outspoken than I am. She's crazy about guys. But she's very ambitious, and that's the only thing I think I can say we have in common, aside from our faces.
Yes, I get you.
And our voices. But she's very ambitious, and right now it's channeled towards being with, you know, being in love. But we have that a lot in our communities, and that's why it's so important that we continue to empower young girls, that they don't need to look to that to be something. That is such an important, love is such an important thing, but you also have power within yourself to become something outside of that, you know?
If you're not inspired after that, then with Ekanewa, Beata, you're bringing the heat here on the show. Please tell us about the different roles you've played, different characters, and what is it like, how do you get into character, how important is that? Yeah, let's speak about that.
I've been so privileged to have the liberty of exploring a few different characters in this year.
Nice.
And what's so important with focusing is just like going home and doing your homework. People think that it's so glamorous.
People think it's easy, ne?
And that you go there and you act and they watch you and they say, yeah, I can also do that. But you go home and you have to
figure out,
even if you have one line that day, have to figure out where it's coming from, how you're going to place it.
Where are you coming from now? How are you feeling that day? How's that character feeling that
day?
Exactly. Yeah,
and because they've been so different, and I had the opportunity to work on Deep State 2 as well, which is the international production. And just seeing the working conditions they have, the working conditions we have, and how we kind of need to meet them somewhere in terms of our artists, and also seeing that we've come a long way and we should be very proud of ourselves for the quality of our work.
So true.
But I've learned, like I said, I've learned so much and
amazing.
Had to really test myself with regard to being committed to each character.
Sure.
And I even played in a horror series, a thriller series in Sprius, and I was a ghost. And it was exciting.
But how mad is
I don't even watch thrillers or horrors.
That's so dope.
It was exciting.
But
because
you get to explore.
Yeah, and you can't worry about what you look like. You can't worry about what people think. You need to worry about being authentic to the character, and that
it's not even about
exciting.
You, yeah. It's not even
it's about you.
Yeah, it's about the bigger picture.
Yeah.
And I mean, how cool is Arendsvlei, you know, creating so much, the platform. What is it like for you being on set there working with everyone? What is it like being part of Arendsvlei?
It's like I said before, you learn every day.
Yes.
It is work. It is not easy. You get tired.
True.
You have to do your homework.
True.
But there are such lovely people on set. I really have, including yourself, people that I can have great conversations
True.
With. We grow as artists. We discuss concepts.
Yes.
We have a fun time. We respect each other. So it's very exciting. And sometimes when you go outside and people recognize you and they say, "Hi, Kim." Sometimes you want to go, but I'm not Kim, because there's things that Kim does that they don't like. But then in saying that, you know, you're a part of their weekly life.
Sure.
And we have such a social responsibility because entertainment educates people, it inspires people, it tells their stories, it heals people. So when they see you in the street, even though that's your first thought, I'm not Kim, your second thought is, you know what? Hello.
Yes.
Come here. Let's take a photo. Let's do what we're going to do and exchange our energies. And then you know you're doing what you need to do.
Oh, I love it, Ben. What would you say? I mean, speaking about the entertainment industry, what's the challenges you think we as artists face in Cape Town or in South Africa?
In South Africa?
In your opinion, of course.
I think there's quite a few.
And how can we obviously try and overcome some of them if we have any solutions?
I think the best thing we can do is to stand together.
Sure.
As performers and artists, you know, in general. We need to make sure that we're taken care of. Like I said, we have a very big social responsibility and we're in people's homes every day. We're a part of their lives. We tell their stories. So we need to take care of ourselves so that we can do that to the best of our abilities.
Amazing.
And that's making sure we're not exploited. That is making sure we can have medical care. It's small things, making sure that we're okay. And I must add that we have come a long way, especially in Cape Town. There is a lot more opportunity that has been created for us, and especially for brown people, which is very exciting. We're not limited to certain roles.
You're right.
As much, especially with something like Arendsvlei, and that's very exciting. So we just need to continue with that, continue to grow, have more producers, have more production houses, create more work, and us as actors, we can also do that.
We don't always have to be in the position.
In front of the camera, and a lot of actors, a lot of artists know that, and that's so exciting. If you if you're on set, and you know this as well, you talk to people, and there's creatives, and we're excited about life and doing things, you know.
Beautifully said, man. And then, I mean, if you look at the industry, I mean, you said about the industry and the challenges that you faced. Would you say, was there ever a moment in your life that you feel that people say failed? I don't like the word fail, but where you feel you failed in something, but it led you to where you are now.
Yeah. Failure is very important.
Yeah, it's so important. I mean, that's just, I don't want to use the word failure because we do need to fail in order to learn, but nonetheless.
And it's not always fail. It can be redirection. You wanted this and you didn't get this, but you're going to get something else. Or you need to learn something else, so you're going to go this way around. So it's redirection. I've had a lot of that. Especially with, like I've mentioned earlier in the interview, with my parents getting divorced. And a lot of people would see that as this hectic thing that is traumatic to a child, but it made my siblings and I smart in a way that nothing else would have.
Sure.
And it exposed us to so much, you know, thinking that we had to do, which we could see as a setback, but ended up making us stronger.
Sure.
And I've got a lot of things like that. Like I did miss Mamelodi Sundowns. In 2017 or 18, it was a bridge between
that time,
and I made it. I won the Western Cape and I made it to the top five.
Amazing.
in the national. And I remember saying, if I place in the top three and I win the prize money, because the Western Cape money I used to pay my studies, my university studies. So if I make it into the top three nationally, then I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. If I don't do it, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. So I made solutions for both sides.
Man.
So then I used that, rather than seeing it as if I win or if I fail, it's
I'm
directed this way or if I'm directed that way. And obviously, because sometimes you want something, but then you're like, okay, you're allowed to feel a bit sad, but then you go this way, and that's how I got my honors. That's how I got onto Arendsvlei. If I went that way, I would not have been in Arendsvlei.
But
I
like
not
the thinking.
Honors, so.
But I love the thinking. It's not like you failed. It's just redirected. I love that you said that. How do you stay motivated to do this every single day? Like, no matter what day, because we all face our challenges every day. But how do you stay motivated to do this every day?
I really value my relationship with God.
Sure.
And my relationship with myself. And knowing that God loves me and that we're supposed to love one another, that's something very important.
Sure.
And always striving to be the version that you know God would be proud of, that God knows that you can be. And saying that without judging other people, without being too hard on yourself as well, I think it's so important to love your neighbor. And it's easy to motivate yourself to be happy when you love your neighbor, because then even if you're having difficulty with maybe work or someone somewhere, you can manage to have, you know, empathy or try and understand where they're coming from. And although you can say that's not okay, you don't feel hate towards them. So
you're
just much more at peace with yourself. And my goal is just to love as happily and joyfully as I can and to my fullest potential.
Sure.
And I value love so much. And when you value love, you find joyfulness and happiness.
Oh,
so that's what motivates me.
Sure. I can't see that your future can't be bright. Like, I can't see that you're not going to be successful. You already are, and I can't see that you can't grow even more into who you are. Because, I mean, of the stuff that you're saying and the way you know who you are, man, and you understand so many things that, I mean, I'm still learning still. So thank you for just being you on the show as well. I mean, let's speak about the highlights, the last few questions, because we're going to do a rap battle at the end, guys. So get ready about cheese. Hello. So just the last few questions. Social media, where can people catch you? If they want to book you, if they want to follow you or support you, please share that with us.
Yes, I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. On Instagram, I'm at Beata_Bena. Mm-hmm. So that's my name and my second name. Mm-hmm. On Facebook, it's also Beata Bena Green. Mm-hmm. So green, like the color, is my surname. And on Twitter, it's exactly the same. So you Amazing. Can catch me there. You can see what I'm up to. Mm-hmm. I'm very excited to engage with anybody.
Love it.
Some of the projects that I've also been doing, we need support for. So
For sure. The last two questions, I like speaking to you. Just any highlights quickly before we go. Highlights in your journey for you. What was the nice moments that you would love to share?
That's a tough one.
Is it too many?
I don't believe in favorites.
There's so many.
You know, sometimes I get a cup of hot chocolate and that is a highlight and I'm like...
But the other... I know what you mean.
Oh, I've got a story.
Tell me.
Okay. So, before we moved from Paul, so I used to stay in Paul and my parents were married.
Yeah.
I discovered this heater, which was a air-blowing heater that was in the wall of my parents' room.
Old school.
Yeah.
Yes, I see.
And I never knew it was there. Mm. And it was winter and they had just gotten divorced and we were about to move out of the house to Strand. Mm. And I discovered this heater and there was a couch next to it. And every single day after school, I would come and I would sit on that couch and I would fall asleep in front of the heater. And it was the best thing ever. And I used to take a blanket and then take it off and feel how it would feel like if I don't have a blanket, and then put it back on and be grateful for having a blanket.
I like that story.
I was so sad when I had to move because I just discovered this, and it was the thing that even when it was hot some days, I would still go and do that. And then years later, I thought that's the thing I miss most, and you know, that memory, I'll never be able to have it back. And then I bought myself a little heater that blows air. And it was in matric just like before my final exams. And I put it on. And I fell asleep. And it took me back.
Wow.
It was the exact same sensation after everything that happened. All the whirlwinds, all the emotional stuff, all the battles, all the overcoming. You have that same exact feeling when I thought I wouldn't have it again. And it's something so small.
Amazing.
And that just opened my mind. It was like life. It's a cycle. And you need to trust it and you need to go with it.
True story.
And you need to appreciate things.
Sure. And I was about to ask you for any advice to the people. I mean, if there's any other advice, because you've been giving advice, I love that. Any advice to the young people watching?
Believe in yourself. Don't wait for people to tell you can do something to do it. Mm-hmm. You can decide. You don't have to be a victim to your circumstances. You can be a product of the choices you make. And then choose love. Don't worry about hate and just like choose love. You know, when you have love, like I said, you find joyfulness and happiness. So believe in yourself and choose love.
Well said. Ah, Beata, it was such a joy to have you on the show. But I mean, right about now, people, it's about to go down. It's about to be a battle. Let's see if her diamond is shining so bright, like she said earlier.
I'm not going to rap.
I want to rap in a battle.
But you must go first.
Must I go first? Okay, because you're the guest. So we're going to rap about cheese because we're out here at Healy's, okay?
Does it have to be only cheese?
Cheese. Here we go. Cheese. Here we go. Me and Beata, we out here, yes. We're eating the cheese out of the fleas. That doesn't make sense, but it's okay. A walk with Mel. Hey.
I like that. Okay.
Here we go.
Mel and Beata eating some cheese. Watch the show. I'm begging you, please. What can you say? I don't know. Hey. Once again, just watch the show.
That was mad. No, that wasn't luck, people. She is actually that brilliant. Please check her out, Beata Green, on all social media platforms. People, she's placed the beautiful Kim on Arendsvlei. So happy to have you on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. Let's
amazing.
Eat some cheese.
Yeah. Oh, we laugh, but we're going to keep it in here.
Mel and Beata sitting at Healy's. What do we know? I don't know.
It's okay. This is the worst that would have come. Come on.
Nothing was...
Maybe a way of expression.
It was...
Expression.
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 Expression. Max.